Hi guys, my name is Muskan Igurani and I'm a professional makeup artist, and in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you guys about project panning, what it is, and I'm going to be sharing with you my first project pan of 2021. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started. What do you mean by project pan? Okay, so basically a project pan means you have to use up a certain amount of products, be it makeup, skincare, hair care, whatever, in a certain amount of time. Okay, so example, it can be 5 products in 6 months, 10 products in a year, and so on and so forth. Okay, so basically a certain amount of products in a particular span of time. So basically you can have different goals, like you can hit pan or you can use up the product completely. Now, why do we do a project pan? We do a project pan so that you can use up makeup products which are going to be expiring, but you don't use them enough. Like for example, if you have a good big collection, okay, so there is a chance that you may don't know when your product is going to expire. Okay, so you search around your collection and there are certain products which are going to expire soon and you want to get the most use out of them before their expiry date. So you put them in a project pan and try to use them all up. Okay, so that's the one way of doing it. The second reason project pan is quite popular is because it will help you understand your collection better. Okay, so for example, people usually have this habit of the one product that you use a lot, they will buy a lot of it, and for most people in cases it's lipstick. Okay, so if you have a for example, if you have a lot of lipsticks, okay, so try using up for example 5 in about a year or in 8-9 months. Okay, then what will happen is you will know that how long it takes for you to actually even go through one lipstick, and that way when you are even buying a drugstore lipstick, which is cheaper option, you will be more considerate while buying it. You will think 2 to 3 times because you will know how hard it is to actually even use up one full lipstick. So you will be more mindful when you're buying it and what you're bringing into your collection. And if you are continuously trying to pan products, you will won't even feel the need to buy any products, because then you will understand how long it takes for you to use that up. So you won't have the urge of buying the new makeup product because you already would know that you have to use up already so much. So you will not buy it, because there are so many makeup releases, and if you are a follower of YouTube and you watch many beauty gurus, you will know that there are so many makeup products always coming out in the market. And yeah, I know many times you do get tempted, right? So this is a good way of using up the collection you have. A third reason the many people do project panning is because it's simply fun. Okay, we used to do projects in school and colleges all the time, and this way is a new type of project which most people haven't done ever. So this way you will know more of your old favorites again, you will use them and fall back in love with them again. And because of the new all the new releases and the new stuff you buy, mostly the old stuff gets neglected, and this way you will use them up again, and you know, give them some love before they expire and you cannot use them anymore. Okay, so these are the main reasons why you do project panning and why is it so popular, and why I also wanted to give it a try and use up many favorites of mine as well, because I don't want to waste the money I've already spent on them. And basically for me this year, it's going to be using up products which are near their expiry. I want to use them before they get expired, and also using up non-cruelty free products, because if you don't know, I have gone cruelty free and I only buy from cruelty free brands since a year now. But before then I used to buy from non-cruelty free brands, and I have a lot of products which are not cruelty free. I'm not going to just throw them away, but I'm trying to use them up. So this year, in the year 2021, I'm planning to pan 10 makeup products. I know these are not too many and not too little, somewhere in the between, and I think the right place for me to start with. Okay, so let's get started with the products. Okay, so let's start with the first product of the 10. It's this Colourbar foundation. It's a stick foundation. Okay, now as you know, if you have seen my favorites video, you would know that Milani and Pack foundations are my favorite, and so this one got a bit neglected in my collection, and that's why I want to use this one up. Okay, it's a good one. It has medium to full coverage and it performs great. I don't have many complaints with it, but I'm not that fond of stick foundations anymore. So I have this one. I want to use this one up before it expires this year, and I don't think it will be a hard job to do so because I'll be using it for my makeup videos, for my YouTube videos. So yeah, I think I can get over this one by the year end. So that's my goal for this year, to get over with this. Next up is this highlighter by YBP. Okay, it's the Shreya Jain one. You can see it has already a bit. I used it up a lot, but there is a lot of amount yet remaining, and I want to use this up fully because again it will get expired this year, and I don't want to, you know, just throw it away without making its full use because it's one of my favorite highlighters. So the next product is this Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer. I've used up quite more than half of it, and only this much is remaining. As you would know, I've gone cruelty free, and I'm trying to use up the products which are not cruelty free in my collection, and Maybelline is one of those brands. And even though I like this concealer a lot, I won't be buying it again, and I want to use this up fully before the year end, and I'm quite confident I will go through it by the year end. Okay, now comes the tough product of this project. This is a lipstick by Lakme. As you can see, a lot of this is remaining, okay, and this will take me a good amount of time to use it up because it's matte and it's a very bright shade. And I don't like to wear such shades very often, and that's the reason I have so much product left. But what I'm trying to do is I'm going to mix it with other lip shades. So I basically mix this with any other lipstick in my collection. I mix it with a gloss, I mix it with a pink, brown, any lipstick, and make new shades for me. That way I'll be creating more new shades for me and using this up as well, because I don't want it to go to waste. It's not a bad shade, but it's particularly not a shade I'm going to be wearing every day because it's really bright. Okay, but I want to use this up because I do like it. It's matte and it stays on for a really long time, so I do like it. So that's why this is going to be really hard. I don't know if I can actually go through the whole thing, but I'll try my very best. Next up are two eyeliners. One is from Maybelline. Okay, again the same reason for Maybelline. Okay, so this you can see, again the same reason for Maybelline. It's a non-cruelty free product and I want to use it up. This will also take me a good amount of time to finish it up, but yeah, let's see. I use it as a kajal as well as an eyeliner. It stays good for a good amount of time on your upper lash line as well, so I like to use it on the upper lash line as well. And second is this blue one by Lakme. Again, this is going to expire this year, but this has a lot less product than that one, and I think I can go through this much faster than that one. So next is an eyeshadow. Okay, I'm just going to brand one single shade. Okay, so this is this taupe shade in this palette. Okay, so this taupe shade right here in this palette. Okay, as you can see, I've been getting already a lot of views on this one. I like to use it during my Insta story videos. I apply it all over my eyes, and it's a very good, great everyday eyeshadow. So yeah, this is a pretty good shade. I like such shades a lot, and I want to use it up every day. And I honestly am kind of liking this shade. It's not very pigmented, but I make it work. And yeah, since it's from Estee Lauder and again a non-cruelty free brand, I want to use it up before it expires. Okay, next up is another heavy item for me. That is all. That eyeshadow and the lipstick are going to be really hard. And again, this one too. This is a blush. This is by LA Girl. Okay, it's one of my favorite blushes, if you know, if you have seen my favorites. But again, I want to hit pan on this one because I use it so much and I cannot see any progress with this one. I want to see more progress, and at least I want to have a dent or a hit pan in this blush by the end of year, and I'm very hopeful that it will happen. Plus, it's not at all tough for me because it's one of my favorite blush. I don't even mind it wearing every day. And the last product for this project is this lipstick, which I'm going to be using it as a blush. Okay, so this is a Faces Canada lipstick in Candy Floss. Okay, I love this shade as a blush more than as a lipstick, and it looks absolutely like a flush of pink on my cheeks, and most people don't even know. They think that I'm naturally blushing, and I love this lipstick as a blush, and I'm going to use it that way as a cream blush. It is for my days. I'm not having much makeup on, just moisturizer, sunscreen, and then this. I do it for my Insta stories and even if I'm going out and about. So yeah, I think I'm pretty sure I'm going to have a very good progress with this one. But again, let's see. I'm hoping for the best. I'm hoping to finish up all these products by the end of year. So this was all. This is what project planning is, and this is what my project looks like for this year. I don't know if I'm going to be doing updates, but I'm directly going to be showing you the final progress in the finale, that is at the end of the year. So make sure to be stay tuning for that. And yeah, make sure to follow me on Instagram, because I do daily makeup tips and tricks over there and give a lot of information on how real life makeup works, okay, on stories, on reels, everywhere. So you will be knowing a lot more makeup knowledge. I do less of reviews, more of makeup knowledge kind of videos. So if that's what you're interested in, then make sure to follow me on Instagram and also subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so that you get notified every time I upload a video. Till next time, bye bye.